Well, it's blowing snow out there. It's minus 13 right now. No, it's minus 17. Excuse me. It's still cold out there. So, yeah, it's supposed to go up to minus 13. So, that's the high of the day. Yay. If you can hear that noise, if Mike's picking it up there, they use a leaf blower to clean the sidewalk off here. It's quite effective, actually. It's easy on the guy's back because he doesn't have to shovel, and it's all nice and clean. Yeah, it works fine. It works fine. It's a good idea. Anywho, don't know if we're going for coffee today or not. I have no idea, but I decided I'm not getting the super deal of toilet paper. I just don't feel like going into a store. I thought donuts would be a more appropriate thing to eat, so I ate donuts. Anyways, the $150 I paid on to my card actually processed overnight. It must have processed last night or this morning sometime, and they start at 5 p.m., I guess it is, and then it takes quite some time sometimes. Sometimes it's done processing a payment by 8, but usually it's much later. But yeah, anyways, it went through obviously because I checked my thing there, and I've got my $50 extra credit, so that's nice. Actually, it's not exactly $50. It's $49.98 that I can spend without going over my little limit here. And I can't go over my limit before the 13th because that's when the cutoff date is, and I want my to be able to order another card with the points that I'll be getting, and if I'm over, they won't let me order the card with the points. So, I should be over the limit to get another $50 Staples gift card. So then, when I get my printer, one of these days, won't be soon, I'll be getting it for free. So, the one I want is about $80, and then after taxes and stuff, it shouldn't be over 100, so or much over 100. There's taxes and there's environmental fees and all that stuff. So my eyes are watering today too. I don't know what the hell, but yeah, they're watering. Lots of phlegm when I woke up this morning too. That's something that I don't usually have happening. So obviously I'm having another allergy attack, or I've got an actual cold, which is highly unlikely because everybody's covering up and washing their hands and stuff now. So it's highly unlikely, but there it is, stuffy nose and all that. Anywho, my stuff was supposed to, my speaker was supposed to be delivered today, but it's going to be here on Wednesday. I got on to chat with Amazon, and I said, "What's with this? You told me the guaranteed date was today, and there's it's coming Wednesday and instead." So they gave me a $10 rebate that as soon as it marks as delivered, they're going to give me a $10 rebate. So, good enough. But that's just. And how's that 2 days delivery, by the way? It shipped yesterday. It's going to be here Wednesday, from Thursday to Wednesday. That's not 2 days. Their 2 day thing seems to be completely meaningless now. So I don't know why they're still promising 2 day delivery when they never really give it to you. So I decided to complain. Yep, and I got $10 from my troubles, I guess. Anywho, snow blowing out there. Yeah, I doubt we'll be going for coffee, so yeah. I can order vodka tomorrow. I can't order it today because they're still in quarantine. Anyways. Yeah, they're in quarantine now. The people that do the delivery, unless I ordered from the other people, which is a little more money to have done, but I would get it today. Yeah, I'll have to know if I'm going for coffee before I do that, though. So, plus I can get something that isn't vodka. I can get my whiskey instead. And then that'll pretty much screw me for spending money. I'll just have coffee money after that. No pizza, no nothing like that. Oh, somebody sent me some money. Thank you, Alex. Thank you, Alex. That was very appreciated. Anywho, it's I like watching the storms. The worse, the better. I always have. Even as a little kid, I liked watching storms. This is not a storm, it's just snowing. But I remember I uploaded one to the Weather Channel the one time that got airplay on the TV. It was a hell of a storm going on here in Moose Jaw, and it was. There was literally flooding over the sidewalk. It was going from the gutters, washing up. It was so intense a rain. Yeah, it was something. It was something, and high winds and all that stuff. Yeah, it was something else. Wish I still had the footage, but I never keep any of my footage. It just takes up too much room, and I don't have millions of hard drives to keep stuff on. So yeah. But I've got thousands of things of fractals and stuff that I've made. I've got all those. I got thousands of photographs. Yeah, we do tend to keep stuff. Speaking of, I went through all my parameters for Mendelbulb 3D. I sorted them out by year, put them in a folder for each year that they are. And the ones that aren't this year, I've zipped to. So, because I'm probably never going to use them again. And if I do, I can just look it up in the zip, it's not a big deal. But every now and then I zip the entire thing because it's a standalone program. It doesn't need an installer. You just put it in there and make a link to the program to run, and away you go, right? Anyways, I zip it now and then so that I don't lose all my parameters and stuff. And that takes a long time when you've got 20,000 parameters. So, and I realized that there were thousands of them in the history folder. Everything I did, everything you've done, there's a limit to the amount of them that it has, but it keeps thousands and thousands of them in the history folder. Everything, the failed attempt that you did is in the history folder. So, it's, and I don't know why, but anywho, I emptied that and there was over 11,000 of them in there, and it took forever for OneDrive to, because it's in a folder that's synced to my cloud. It took forever for OneDrive to go, okay, because I had cleaned out those 11,000 there, and the 25,000 odd, or it's over 20,000 anyways, 25 or 28,000 parameters that I had archived into zips. It took forever for it to process all those, because it's not a very fast and efficient way of doing things, the OneDrive way. So, anyways, but it freed up a bunch of space. Not that I need it. I've got a terabyte of cloud storage, and I'm about 110 gigabytes right now. that I'm using, so it's not a huge amount. I thought about going through all my stuff and my media-sized art for images that and sorting them out by year and archiving them like that, but I don't think I have to because I don't regularly do anything with them. I just store them in there and that's that. If I was zipping them like I do this thing, it would take forever to zip all those, but yeah. And no need to sort them. They're already date coded and stuff like that, most of them. So easy to find if somebody wants one to make a print from and whatnot. By the way, I posted one last night. It's date coded for today, but I posted it last night because I rendered it last night instead of today. That I don't think I should have said in there that it has non-standard I don't know why I can't remember this word. I couldn't remember it yesterday. Formulas. So I should have said that in there before somebody copies the parameter and goes, it doesn't work. But yeah, they're easy to find, but you actually have to install them manually. So, anyways, yeah, maybe I'll do that today. Change the description to denote that. Anyways, y'all have a fabulous day. Keep smiling.